Hello everyone, it is I, Mark Major, a person who does not hide behind a mask or an alias, and behind me here you can see the Action Figure Torium. Yes, it's a physical place that you can visit. I'm in it now, and I'm reporting to you from the ground level. Now, today I'm going to be looking at another Kickstarter which just launched. It's in its first 24 hours. It is a line of 3-inch action figures, fantasy action figures. So we're going to get lizard men, we're going to get barbarians, and it is specifically for the Glyos system, which is a sort of toy standard that a company came up with several years ago in which certain approved manufacturers are allowed to make figures for. It means that the parts are all interchangeable and swappable with any other product in the line, but any other toy manufacturer who uses the system. So this is going to be kind of exciting. Also, these guys seem to have done well in the past. I'm not really familiar with this company. What are they called? I believe it's Rocom Toys. But it looks like this is probably going to be a big hit. I've looked a little bit at the Kickstarter already, and I think this is going to be a solid one. So everybody needs to just come together, strap on the leather, and hold on tight. So let's cut over to the Kickstarter. And I think we should start off by maybe playing their intro video. I think the intro video gives you a pretty good marketing idea of what the product is. Also, you can sort of see how professional these cats are. And, you know, it's also a good way if you're looking to invest in a Kickstarter to see if this is worthy of funding in terms of, like, are they going to take your money and run off with it? There's always that chance. So this is always a good way to blow the foam off the beer. You guys ready for this? Let me turn on the desktop audio. Okay, here we go. Good so far. Let's take a full screen. Look at that. So these aren't the actual products. I mean, this is just a digital render. But it's done well. Okay, you got some like Rage Against the Machine style music. Made especially for them. Very glossy. Only figures, people. Gravestone. Ram. Lahan. Moonlight. Deathstroke. He looks cool. Very Mad Max. Thrasher. Look at that guy. Look at that dude. That's a cool looking guy. He got kind of a motion feel to him.
Mighty Maniax from Rocom Toys. Right. Available now only on Kickstarter.
So they got the guy from Honest Trailers to do a little voiceover plug. That costs money. Let's watch one more vid. This is kind of a history about the line. This might be important for some people if you're unsure as to whether or not you can trust these guys. You see, they have a history of making toys and being successful. So let's check out a little bit.
Mighty Maniax was originally funded on Kickstarter in October of 2020. Since then, it's been 4 years of creating hundreds of action figures, from robots and monsters to street brawlers and
slashers. These guys look cool.
It represents all the things I loved growing up.
Oh, how that's legal to use.
From action movies and horror to sci-fi and video games. One of the most fun things to see is how much kids connect with the toys.
Kind of changing up those Mighty Maniacs.
All right, so first of all, I hate kids, and I don't want to see them in my videos, but...
Thank you, Rocom!
I remember growing up with certain toys that are really nostalgic to me.
This guy looks cool. He looks like he's a roadie for Slayer.
It's so cool to think that Mighty Maniacs can be that for another generation. Mighty Maniacs Dark Earth is now expanding the line into barbarians and fantasy characters. Highly influenced by Frazetta's Conan, video games like Golden Axe or
Golden Axe.
And definitely
there are Golden Axe action figures
like Jurassic Park and anime.
Out there,
when I set out to design the Mighty Maniacs Barbarian, I definitely wanted to do something different. Growing up, there weren't very many Indian characters to look.
Okay, I think we've gotten enough juice. Let's dig into the Kickstarter now. I think we've paid our dues. We've seen the marketing. And I'm willing to concede that these cats, Rocom Toys, are probably the real deal. So let's just scroll through what the product is. It looks like there is, okay, here's sort of the stuff they have for sale. So you can get a PDF coloring page. It's just a drawing of a dude or maybe some sort of a 3D render of a dude that's allows you to, you know, print off a copy and doodle on it. That's cool for a buck. That's a good idea. You can download the theme song for $5. That's a good idea. That doesn't cost them. I mean, they spent money on the song. Who knows? Maybe somebody will just, as they're buying a bunch of these, will just throw in another $5 for the song. It's worth it. Enamel pin for $10. That's probably easy to fulfill. Probably get them made cheaply and quickly, maybe even the United States. And that way, if people are waiting a year to get their, or 2 years to get their action figures, if you can, you know, after like 3 or 4 months, you can send them a pin or something like that. That's a good way to go. So there is a collection of weapons for $12. You can buy just a blank unpainted figure for $14 as an add-on. I think that's a pretty good idea. There's, of course, trading cards, $15 for those. That's a great idea. Easy to print, easy to ship out and keep people happy for a little bit. One of the things I talk about in my best practices video, my Marketing 101 Essentials, in which we're going to get to the three main things, but there are some other things, and one of them was that if you pad out your Kickstarter with these kind of tchotchkes, as I call them, you know, sort of keychains and pins and, you know, watch bands and stuff like that, necklaces and things like that, and maps, you know, PDFs of comic books, it's a great way to, like, just get, like, extra sort of things in the cart for people at checkout, make some extra money on the side. It also fills it out, makes it look like you've got a lot going on when you don't. This is all top-notch stuff I'm seeing. Okay, so here we get to the figures. Base guy comes with an extra head, which is cool. Thrasher, $20. It looks really cool. Again, these guys, they're only 3 inches. They've got kind of that hulking He-Man feel to them, which I think is a good thing. I think for fantasy figures and little sort of action figures like that, I think it's a good route to go, believe it or not. I don't think that this is necessarily where you want to have the 31 pieces of articulation. And of course, this is the Glyos system. So if you have a bunch of Glyos figures, these are just going to be more kind of cool fodder for you. But there's a blue guy and a red guy. They use the same buck, but different heads, different sculpts to an extent. And then, of course, there's an exclusive who's a translucent guy for a couple bucks more. All right, so now we get to the human bucks. And these guys are $24, but they come with a weapon, and they come with two heads instead of one. So for the extra money, right, although these guys are bumping you up, they're giving you a little bit more stuff, which is pretty cool. And there's one, two, three, four, five of these guys. The fifth guy is an extra buck above them, but you get three heads instead of two heads. So that's very cool, in my opinion. I think that's the way to do it. And of course, they've got some nice sort of package figures if you're going to buy a couple together. It's kind of a deal. There's like a couple two-packs here. Original sketch card as an add-on. That's sure. Okay, why not? Someone might buy it. Also, that might be the thing that years later is really rare and valuable. So that might be for somebody who's looking to buy Kickstarter products as a future, as an investment of something they're going to resell later, 10, 20 years from now. Put it away, put it on the shelf, you know, things are getting old. Bring it out. Always a good idea. The early base set. So you could get kind of everything here for $175, but if you get in early, it's $150. Save $25. That's like a free figure. Already sold out. We're not even officially 24 hours into this thing, and they have used up all the early birds. So there's the big sort of all in, as it is, for $175. And then there's some kind of crazy super pack for $500. And we're going to talk about this in a minute. This is a great idea too, and I'll bring up a graphic here and I'll tell you guys why. All right, let's bring up our best practices, marketing 101 for Kickstarters. First thing, three-tier pricing. You need a cheap thing that everybody can buy. You need to have a deluxe thing, and then you need to have a luxury thing. Remember, with the luxury thing, it's for people who have a lot of disposable income and will spend it on the most expensive thing simply because it exists, in which case, why not make it exist so that you can have somebody's disposable income? These guys definitely, with this campaign, have the cheap item with the enamel pin and some of the other stuff with the MP3 and the coloring book, but also the entry-level figure at $20, I think definitely classifies as an entry-level thing. If you just want to buy 20 bucks for one figure, you can do that. Now, second thing is a deluxe item. They have figures for 24, 25 bucks. They come with extra weapons and heads. I definitely think that counts as a deluxe item. And then there's the luxury item. I did not see specifically a luxury item for this, but I also have to say that for these guys to really make a luxury item, usually it's something kind of bigger, kind of more unusual and gaudy in terms of like a paint scheme. And that would mean they would be off the Glyos system. And so to make a real luxury figure, they would have to come up with some sort of unusual head sculpt, unusual weapons, and unusual paint for a figure. And I don't really see this happening. However, they do have that $500 mega pack. And I'm going to say that that is, for the most part, their luxury item in this campaign. And so I'm going to say these guys check all the boxes. Okay, the next thing is the wider selection. We have seen that they've got a couple of lizard men and then five other guys in the barbarian class. And the fact that you can get a few different guys, they give you some different heads and you can pop and swap and make different figures, I think they've got a very wide selection to go on. And if they unlock any other figures, that selection is just going to get wider. All right, the last thing is all your marketing on one page. Their marketing looks great. The video looks great. They've got another video underneath it just talking about the company and the previous toy lines, and then they've got another video under that, which we didn't look at, which they just go through the Glyos system. And so everything that I'm seeing here looks absolutely fantastic. Okay, let's denote that we have seen all the rewards. Let's go through them, just mention them real quick. There's a coloring page for $1. We showed that the theme song is $5. The enamel pin is $10. But if you get the enamel pin, it also includes the dollar coloring page and the $5 song. So if you're going to buy those anyways, both of them for $6, for an extra $4, you get a pin. Trading card set. I don't know how many come in the set, but they also give you the song and the pin with it, and that's only $15. Now we get to the figures. You can see with the figures that they also throw in the song, the page, and a single trading card. A single trading card for each guy. $20 for the lizard man, $22 for the exclusive. Now, I noticed that the exclusive also comes with an enamel pin by Dan Larson. I'm assuming that Dan Larson here is the Dan Larson from another YouTube channel called Toy Galaxy, or maybe Secret Galaxy, or maybe Secret Toy Galaxy. I don't know what it's called, but I love his channel. I'm a subscriber to it. I watch most, if not all, of his little mini documentaries that he does on toys, as well as cartoons from the 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000s, that kind of thing. He does these great histories. I really do appreciate the Secret Toy Galaxy channel. However, Dan Larson himself on Twitter is annoying. I had to block him just in case somebody accidentally reposted him and showed up in my feed. But other than that, if he's involved with this Kickstarter, it's probably pretty good. It's probably going to fund and they're not going to take off with the money. Of course, I did make that video, Kickstarters that funded but never fulfilled. It was people who had a great idea, a great product. They got the money for it and then they never delivered. They took off with the money. And you have to vet all these guys every single time. And even if they've done a Kickstarter before and they fulfilled it, things go south for people. Bills come up. They've got a bunch of money sitting in the bank. They figure they'll make it up somewhere else. Next thing you know, you're not getting your toys. So let's keep going. The barbarian looking dudes, $24. Of course, they also, include the extra head and weapon. So the four extra dollars versus the $20 lizard man, it looks like a good deal to me. And anytime you can make more value by throwing in these simple things like the MP3 and the coloring page, they don't cost these guys anything to really manufacture compared to, like, say, having a mold built, having injection plastic put into it and painted and packaged and shipped from China. If you can just send somebody a pin or an MP3 or a coloring page, that's always a great way to add value without increasing your overhead. You can see the four guys here. And of course, the $25 guy, actually looks like there's two guys for $25. Interesting. I thought it was just this guy, Death Row. This is the coolest looking guy. This is the one that I would buy. But I think overall this is a great looking Kickstarter. We've got the battle packs here. If you're just going to buy a couple of them anyways, why not get a few bucks off? And we need to look at the fact that the early bird, the first 50 people picked this up quickly. It's only within the first 24 hours and people have already bought it out. But even then, 22 people came along after the fact when it was bought out and still bought the $175 sort of all-in. The Mega Hoarder Pack, 4 people have picked that up. That's $2,000 for just that alone. Like I said, if it's a luxury item, somebody out there with the money will buy it. And you're looking at it right here. So that's the rewards. And I think, let's go back to the main campaign here. I think that this is definitely going to fund. It's within 24 hours and they're already at 62%. Now the goal is $30,000 for a 6-inch figure. Right? With the mold and the cost to produce, most Kickstarters try to get around $100,000 plus or minus. The fact that they're doing little 3-inch guys and they're only doing 2 different bucks means that the molds with the heads and everything, probably around 5 to 10 grand for each mold, and then plus an extra 10 grand to get everything produced, you know, the materials and the service of painting them, packaging them, shipping them, all that needs to be covered. But $30,000 is a pretty low ask for action figures these days. And so I think that they're pretty easily going to hit that and probably pretty soon, probably within a week. And I'm going to say that these guys are probably going to hit about a little over $100,000 with this. If it goes higher than that, well, congratulations to them. They have a great looking campaign. They're hitting all the marks. It really just comes down to then whether or not you like the toy. And so here's where I'm going to leave my sort of objective marketing hat behind and get into the subjective Mark Major action figuratorium. Let's take a look at the figures one more time and let's just give a little bit of blather as to whether or not we think these are particularly cool or not. Of course, they only have 3D renders of these guys. Maybe these are a 3D print that they have painted up. The shots look really good, though, of these, whatever these are, whether they're a 3D render or an actual 3D print that has been photographed. I think that the bodies on these guys, the weird scaly lizard men things, I think that these look particularly interesting and cool. They have a little bit of the Battle Beast He-Man Motu thing going on with them, and I think the fact that they're part of this interchangeable system can only help. I also kind of like the barbarian looking guys. I'm not really into the schwammy looking headpiece on the dude, but I think the weird horned helmet guy in the kind of Danzig looking stage clothes is particularly cool. And in fact, the Death Throw guy, if I'm gonna buy one of these, I think that's the one that I would actually back and throw down for. That's the one that's kind of got me hooked. And I think these are cool guys. I think if you're into this system, I think you're definitely going to be buying these. And you're probably gonna be buying quite a few so that you can just mix and match and make as many different figures as you want from them. If there was any way to get these even cheaper to like $15, wow, I think that they would sell a ton of them. They wouldn't make a lot of money at that point per figure, but they would move a lot of product. So, I think that's going to conclude this sort of survey of the Mighty Maniax. This is going to be a hit, people. This is going to be a big hit for them. And it looks like this is a company that has put out several hits in the past. And it looks to me like there's going to be several more hits in the future for them. And if you liked what you saw here, yeah, feel free to let them know that you saw it on the Action Figuratorium and that you're now going to be funding their campaign. It'd be great if this channel could actually make a difference for these indie toy companies and help people find cool things that they didn't know existed. So, everybody who made it this far in the video, you guys are great. And of course, as always, stay charged.